My name is Emily Puckett. I'm 32 years old, and I'm a graduate research assistant at the University of Missouri. For my bachelor's, I studied botany, and for my master's, I studied plant physiology.
Okay. And what were your hobbies outside of school?
In high school, I danced and played in band, and in college, I think I napped a lot. I've wanted to be a scientist probably since I was 5 years old, and the first time I knew I was interested in science, I was in the library checking out books in kindergarten or first grade, and I came across a zoology book for elementary school, and I just loved all of the animals there, and I think what I really wanted to be was a zookeeper, but I also knew that somehow at such a young age, I knew that research, I would at least have the potential to hurt animals, and so that's where I became interested in plants, because I was like, I can do science, but with plants, and then I don't have to hurt any animals. And it wasn't until much later in life that I realized that some of the non-invasive techniques that we use in our lab could help me work with animals, especially in a conservation context, but also not have to hurt them at the same time. I think what our lab does is a genetic natural history. So when we think about natural history, oftentimes we're going out and understanding how animals or plants live in the environment, what their life cycle is like, what their life form is like, how their populations change over seasons or with perturbance to their environment. And what we do here is we take and add a genetic component, and that helps us understand diversity, genetic diversity in a species or a population, understand how the population size has changed over time and what population structure and gene flow are like in the natural populations that we study. My PhD dissertation project is on the phylogeography and population genetics of the American black bear. So we're interested in how the genetic lineages change over time, and then how we can explain what we see today based on what we know about the past.
What questions are you trying to answer?
The phylogeographic question is related to how lineages are spaced on the landscape and how they got to be there based on what we know of the climate record. And why that's important is when we look across species, we find certain areas of geography that are barriers to species, and that they can create different genetic lineages on either side of the barrier. And the reason that's important is that if populations aren't on either side of a barrier, are not exchanging migrants, then they can drift to different places. And that's a main driver of speciation processes. Speciation is how species form. Species form when there are reproductive barriers. So species that are closely related, some of them can breed and create hybrids, but some of them can't breed. And that's a marker of being different species. So when we think about speciation processes, we're really interested in what are the genetic and phenotypic changes that are keeping species apart so that things don't homogenize.
Puckett is most interested in the questions her research provokes.
Everyone gets to their PhD dissertation a different way. So when I contacted my advisor, she said, "How do you feel about bears?" And I was like, "Whatever." And that was fine. I'm fairly agnostic to species. I'm fairly agnostic to the species that I work on. I'm more interested in the questions.
What do you like about working in the lab?
The ebbs and flows of it being fun and then it not being fun and you really wanting to get on to the next step keeps it dynamic enough to always be interesting, because you're always learning new things yourself and telling the world about new knowledge that you've helped generate. And that's just an amazing opportunity and so satisfying. In terms of working by myself or working with colleagues, I like them both. In the lab, I love to work by myself, just zone out and do lab work for hours. But I like working with my colleagues in the stage of the process where we're generating new ideas, because you can be super smart, but the super smart person next to you probably has an idea that you don't have, and it's only by talking to them over coffee or at the gym or swiveling your chair around in lab and chatting and asking a question where you learn so much by working with your lab mates.
Puckett offered some advice to aspiring researchers.
I think the biggest obstacle that scientists face, especially young scientists, is moving past your own insecurities, because when everyone you see in a day is super smart and you respect them for their intellect, it can be really easy to beat yourself up and say, I'm not that smart. How do I deserve to be here? But just when you keep working and you keep learning and you keep growing and you get a little success under your belt, that helps a lot. Ultimately, you get to a point where you realize that you do deserve to be there.